In my commentary tonight, I need to talk to you about a terrible plague spreading across the United States and the world. No, not another COVID outbreak. I'm talking about the plague of anti-Semitism. This isn't a new phenomenon. The Pharaoh enslaved the entire nation of Israel in the Bible. Haman tried to annihilate the entire Jewish race. King Nebuchadnezzar threw Jews into the fiery furnaces. Yet anti-Semitism wasn't limited to biblical times. In the 1940s, anti-Semitism reached genocidal levels in Nazi Germany, and now it's spiking again. According to the Anti-Defamation League, anti-Semitic attacks reached an all-time high in the United States in 2021. Attacks against Jewish community centers and synagogues were up 61%. Incidents at K-12 schools increased 106%. Incidents on college campuses rose 21%, and physical assaults against Jews in the United States shot up 167%. That's why I was horrified that last week, former President Donald Trump met at Mar-a-Lago with two men who were seething with hatred towards Jews. One was rapper Kanye West, whom I've had to repeatedly denounce on this show for his revolting comments against Jews.
You're not Hitler. You're not a Nazi. You don't deserve to be called that and demonized.
Well, I see good things about Hitler also. I love everyone, and Jewish people are not going to tell me you can love, us, and you can love what we're doing to you with the contracts, and you can love what we're, what we're pushing with the pornography. But this guy that invented highways, invented the very microphone that I use as a musician. You can't say out loud that this person ever did anything good. And I'm done with that. I'm done with the classifications. Every human being has something of value that they brought to the table, especially Hitler.
The other Trump guest was Nick Fuentes. He calls himself a Christian, but he's not. He's in fact a white supremacist and a Holocaust denier.
The Antichrist is the Jewish state of Israel. The Antichrist, this organized Jewish influence set against a real one who challenged God's authority first. We all know. He came down from heaven like a bolt of lightning, and he knew that he didn't have much time, and he's got a bed made up for you in hell, and we know who it is. A different prince, the prince of this world, the prince of the worldly. Who else would be leading the revolution? Who else would be leading the insurrection against the true kingdom? And against the representative of that supernatural kingdom on earth? Who else would be behind it other than the devil? You could say, it's the left, and behind that is the Jews, and behind that is the devil.
Max says, if I take 1 hour to cook a batch of cookies and Cookie Monster has 15 ovens working 24 hours a day, every day for 5 years. How long does it take Cookie Monster to make 6 million batches of cookies? I don't know. That's a good question. Certainly. Oh, no. It doesn't really sound correct to me. Wait a second. It takes 1 hour to cook a batch of cookies and you have 15 ovens, probably in four different kitchens, right? Doing 24 hours a day, every day for 5 years, how long would it take you to make 6 million? I don't know. It certainly wouldn't be 5 years, right? The math doesn't seem to add up there. The math doesn't quite seem to add up there. I don't think you'd result in 6 million.
This is absolutely sickening. Look, I've met with President Trump twice. I don't agree with him on everything, but I like him. He's not an anti-Semite. He was the most pro-Israel and pro-Jewish president in the history of the country. But this meeting was an unmitigated disaster. Yet rather than apologize, Trump is defending his meeting with Kanye and insisting he didn't know who Fuentes was. But Trump's closest Jewish friends and advisors are calling him out. Incoming Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu this week criticized Trump's judgment for meeting with these guys. David Friedman, who worked for Trump for decades and served as his ambassador to Israel, tweeted this: "To my friend Donald Trump, you are better than this. Even a social visit from an anti-Semite like Kanye West and human scum like Nick Fuentes is unacceptable. I urge you to throw those bums out, disavow them, and relegate them to the dustbin of history where they belong. Jason Greenblatt is another Orthodox Jewish lawyer who worked for Trump for decades and then served as his chief Middle East negotiator. He wrote, "The dinner should not have happened, period. I hope that President Trump condemns Fuentes, West, and their ilk for what they are, haters of Jews and haters of the foundations of the United States of America. People like Fuentes are dangerous to the United States. The President Trump that I know would recognize that and issue this condemnation." Unfortunately, as of this broadcast, Trump has not issued such a condemnation. Also unfortunate, I've heard almost nothing from evangelical leaders on this, except for former Vice President Mike Pence, who said this during a media tour for his new book, So Help Me God.
President Trump was wrong to give a white nationalist, an anti-Semite, and a Holocaust denier a seat at the table. And I think he should apologize for it, and he should denounce those individuals and their hateful rhetoric without qualification. With that being said, as I point out in the book as well, I don't believe Donald Trump is an anti-Semite. I don't believe he's a racist or a bigot. I would not have been his vice president if he was. And you know, people often forget the president's daughter converted to Judaism.
Yep.
His son-in-law is a devout Jew. His grandchildren are Jewish. And so I, you know, the broad brush of attack that media leveled at him, but I think the president demonstrated profoundly poor judgment in giving those individuals a seat at the table. And as I said, I think he should apologize for it. He should denounce them without qualification.
Well put, and kudos to Pence for being a voice of moral clarity. Look, I can't think of a more terrible way for Trump to kick off a third presidential campaign. His poll numbers are still strong, but they've been drifting downward, and this is a major unforced error. In many ways, Trump has been a great asset to conservatives and specifically to evangelicals, and I continue to pray for him daily. But let's be honest, some of the moves that he's made in recent years are eroding his support in the evangelical world. And embracing two anti-Semites amidst a rising tide of anti-Semitism is going to make things worse.